Hey, I'm Alice.
Hey guys, it's Bella. Breaking Twilight video.
And today we're talking about the Breaking Dawn quotes, all 20 of them.
I am extremely excited that we made this, or made Breaking Twilight, because this is like insane. Yes, I'm beyond excited. Okay, enough about that. So, a quick reason why this video is so soon is because Alice is leaving on vacation for 2 weeks, and I'm really sad about it. So, we're doing a video so you can see us together somewhat before she leaves. So, after this, I think for the next 2 weeks, I will probably be filming by myself, and I'm going to be really sad. So, this video, we're just going to talk about our theories on the Breaking Dawn quotes so you can see kind of what we're like before she leaves. And then, after when she gets back, we're going to do a totally extravagant video, throw this huge party, and yeah, it'll be amazing. You guys will love it. So, on to the quotes.
Okay, so, first one is where Alice and Edward are playing rock, paper, scissors for this mysterious cause. Well, I'll read it out. Alice, I'll play for it. Rock, paper, scissors. Edward, why don't you tell me who wins? Alice, I do. Excellent. Yeah, I have no idea what it could be about, but it's obviously one of those many little arguments between Alice and Edward and what they want to do with something else. Yeah, I have no idea.
The first quote. What do I think about it? I don't know. I thought it was pretty funny, I'll admit, and it's just like total Alice-Edward moment, so yay for that. The second quote, Bella, oh Mike, how will I go on? Okay, I laughed when I read this quote. I think it's just Bella kind of like being overdramatic and Mike trying to like, I don't know, maybe try to like convince her not to do the wedding and like threaten her that he won't be her friend anymore. Be like, I won't be your friend. And she's like, oh, how will I go on? I don't know, but hey, that's my theory.
What I think about the second one. Bella probably is just overreacting with the whole, I don't want everyone to know that I'm engaged thing, and she's being all, oh Mike, how can I go on, because she, like, she's always melodramatic about these things, you know, she doesn't want everyone to know she's engaged, and she thinks that she'll be, like, ridiculed or something. That's my thing. Okay, so the third one, where Tanya says, Edward, I've missed you. I think it's actually one of two things. Either Edward goes to Denley, or is that how you pronounce it? To, visit Tanya and their clan to invite them to the wedding. Or, like, Edward could have just been formal and sent them an invitation, and she could have come and this could have been, like, at the wedding.
I don't like this quote. It gives me wrong ideas, like Tanya's touching Edward and being like, oh, how I've missed you, and blah, 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 blah. Ew, get out of this book, Tanya. You're not gonna ruin it. Bella is gonna marry Edward. End of story. Okay, quote number 4. Ooh, scary. Emmett is amazing. Oh my god, he's hilarious. I love him. So that quote is pretty funny. What does it mean? I don't know. I don't know. Let's just leave it at it's pretty funny, and it's just Emmett.
And I love Emmett's line. Ooh, scary. Okay, this one, I think... I don't know why I think again. I just... It's Emmett. He's being Emmett. That's my theory. Okay. So, this one, Bella says, Jasper, what do vampires do for bachelor parties? You're not taking him to a strip club, are you? That one's pretty much self-explanatory. Okay.
I love this quote. I read it the first time and it made me laugh so much. I think a lot of these quotes have. So yeah, I laughed a lot. I think it's pretty self-explanatory, so I'm not going to really go in detail on it. Okay, quote number 6. Bells were up to bat. Okay, I think this has to do with... It's nothing to do with baseball. Like, when I first read it, I'm like, what, baseball? But then I kind of figured it was like Charlie saying, oh, it's time to go down the aisle, so now we're up to bat kind of thing. Could be, could not be. We have one more day. Or if this comes up tomorrow, then something hours. I don't know when this will be up. Hopefully soon.
Ooh, they're obviously going to play baseball. And yeah, that's pretty much it. It's pretty obvious. Okay, so, this one, Edward says, you're awfully small to be so hugely irritating. Yeah, it's most probably to Alice, and Alice is being Alice about the wedding or whatever. And Edward doesn't really approve, as usual.
Again, I laughed. I don't know really what it has to do or what the meaning is, but it's funny. yeah, I don't know. It probably has to do with Alice, because Alice is always annoying Edward. Number 8. Why am I covered in feathers? And this is a Bella quote. Okay, it has to do with, it just has to do with, like, Alice in the wedding dress and trying to figure it out. So she's like, why am I covered in feathers? Because you know Alice should go extravagant on the dress.
And this one is probably just some random thing. I have no idea. Yeah, I'm out. It's like every second one I'm out. Stupid stuff. Okay, so, number 9. Alice says, no one will dare call you plain when I'm through with you, Bella, only because they're afraid you'll suck their blood. Once again, I'm kind of stumped. Yeah, I don't know. It could be something either like fashion crisis that Bella usually has and Alice has to take care of, or wedding dress crisis thing or something. I have no idea. I'm just trying to get through the wedding. I pray to God to get married.
Okay. Number 9. Again, I think this is kind of self-explanatory because there's nothing really to expect. It's just probably during the wedding. I don't know. There's nothing really else to say. Same with number 10, Edward. Oops. That could mean anything. So, honestly, I don't know. Maybe he dropped Bella again after running or something. Like, I don't know. Yeah.
And this one doesn't count. Number 10 should just be removed. It shouldn't count. Okay. 11. Renee. Alice wouldn't let us do anything else. Every time we tried, she all but ripped out our throats. Ripped our throats out. Yeah. Once again, one of my many wedding theories where Renee's trying to help out with the wedding and Alice won't let her. Pretty much. That's all I can say to that.
Again, kind of self-explanatory. Probably at the wedding, Alice wouldn't let Renee do anything. Like, mothers are supposed to, but we all know how Alice is.